Hi fellow vet techs, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Monica and I make videos all about tips and tricks for vet techs. In today's video, I'm going to go over some vet tech essentials. Let's start off with apparel. As a vet tech, you'll need to wear scrubs. There are many hospitals and clinics that'll give you a scrub allowance when you get hired and usually once a year thereafter. If your place of work buys your scrubs, they may have a certain style, color, and brand that they require you wear. Many hospitals do this so that the staff all look the same and more professional. If you work for a hospital or clinic that requires you buy your own scrubs, there are a number of places you can buy them. You can go shop online, uniform stores, and Walmart. If you've never shopped for scrubs before, you will quickly learn that they are pretty expensive, especially in more fashionable scrubs. If you're having to buy your own scrubs, I recommend going to Walmart. They have a nice, affordable variety of scrubs. One tip I can give you is always keep a clean pair of scrubs in your locker or car. You never know when you will get some type of bodily fluid on you, such as anal glands, pee, poop, or vomit. The next item is going to be spandex or biker shorts to wear under your scrubs. When working with animals, you'll be bending over, lying on the floor, and getting in weird positions when restraining large animals. Because of this, you will get plumber's crack. I guarantee you will see every one of your coworkers' butt crack at least once when working as a tech. To prevent this, wear spandex or biker shorts. Your coworkers will thank you. Next is shoes. As a vet tech, you're on your feet most of the day and for long hours. I recommend a comfortable shoe. I personally like athletic shoes such as Nike or Asics. These are good, comfortable shoes that last a long time. Other types of shoes used in veterinary medicine are nursing clogs. These are comfortable, durable shoes human nurses wear. Other popular shoes I've seen in hospitals are Crocs. Crocs have a variety of different styles. The tennis shoe style is very popular in my place of work. I work with doctors and techs that love these shoes and recommend them for veterinary medicine. No matter what type of shoe that you find best for you, I do recommend you choose a shoe that is dark in color. Black, dark gray, dark blue, etc. Veterinary medicine is a dirty job and I guarantee you will get dirty and you will get some type of bodily fluid on you at some point. The next is compression socks. This one may not be for everyone, but can also be a lifesaver since you're on your feet all day. I personally don't wear compression socks every day, but when I did develop plantar fasciitis from being on my feet all day, they were the only thing that helped me get through my day and heal my poor feet. The last apparel item is going to be sleeves. Again, this one may not be for everyone. I have personally worked for hospitals and clinics that were very strict about tattoos, piercings, and unnatural hair color. I highly recommend that before you go get any of these done, you check with your hospital's handbook. If you do have tattoos, you may be asked to cover them up with sleeves. Any tattoos on the neck or face may need to be covered up with makeup. I've also seen people use band-aids to cover up tattoos. The next vet tech essential is hair ties. Always keep a hair tie with you or keep your hair up. Again, this is a dirty job, and when your hair is down, you risk some kind of bodily fluid or medication getting in your hair. Also, you need to be alert when working with animals. If your hair is in your face blocking your view, it can be pretty dangerous and an easy way to get yourself bit. The next essential item, and most important, is a pen. Always have a pen or two on you at all times. You can either buy your own pens, or most hospitals and clinics usually have them floating around. Keeping a pen on you is very important. You never know when you will need a pen to write something down, such as a drug dose or a number in an emergency. In this case, you don't want to be running around trying to find a pen. Next is a Sharpie. As a vet tech, Sharpies are so important. I can guarantee you will need a Sharpie as much as you need a pen. Sharpies are used to label items such as blood tubes, urinary samples, and fecal samples. I also use a Sharpie to label my syringes with medication. Labeling your syringes is so important. You may have two or three medications and syringes to give to a patient, and it's vital they are labeled so you know what is being given and how. Some medications are IV, some sub-Q, and some are oral. Label your meds is very important. There are different types of Sharpies. I prefer the dual tip Sharpie. It is the fine tip at one end and ultra fine tip at the other. You should have both of these types of Sharpies in your pocket at all times. The dual tip is nice So you only have one Sharpie and it limits the items you have in your pocket and one less thing to misplace. One tip I can give you is label your pens and Sharpies with a label maker or color tape to indicate they belong to you and prevent them from being picked up by someone else. The next item is going to be a stethoscope. It doesn't matter what type of stethoscope, but it's always good to have your own. I will say that in some hospitals and clinics, you're not going to use it a whole lot, but it's still good to have. Lots of hospitals have communal stethoscopes that everyone can use. Even though this is nice, it's really gross. They are in everyone's ears, and when you clean them out, you'll understand what I mean when I say gross. I work in emergency and specialty hospital, and currently I'm working in the ICU. I use my stethoscope every day. It's not required to have a stethoscope, but it is recommended. Especially in an emergency, it's not an ideal to be running around looking for a stethoscope. The next three items are all related and each recommended and important to have on you. The first is going to be bandage scissors. Get yourself a nice pair of bandage scissors to keep on you. I have worked at many different hospitals, and finding a good pair of bandage scissors when you need them is always a struggle. I couldn't tell you how many times our hospital has bought bandage scissors for us to use and somehow magically disappear from the drawer constantly. Save yourself the hassle. Get yourself a pair to keep in your pocket. A tip I can tell you is to label your scissors so that everyone knows they belong to you if you put them down somewhere. Another tip is not to purchase these utility scissors. You don't want these big, bulky ones. They don't work well, and they're just too big. This is the type of scissor you will want to purchase. The next is hemostats. Like bandage scissors, having a good pair of hemostats on you at all times is ideal. Hemostats may not be used as often, but when you or the doctor need them, it's good to be able to just pull them out and not have to go around trying to find a pair. Which brings me to my next item, suture scissors. This is another item that is needed as a vet tech and hard to locate in the hospital when needed. Which suture scissors, I recommend you get the small ones like this. The hook is nice and small to get in tight areas such as NG tube suture to the nose or Tomcat catheter suture on a prepuce of a cat. If the suture scissor is too big, you can pinch or cut the patient when trying to remove sutures in delicate areas. The next item I feel that is good to have is a thermometer. I know that a lot of you are going to say, oh, my clinic or hospital have those, which is fine and they should have them available. I know that for me, when I worked in specialty surgery and now in ICU, I found that having my own thermometer is very useful. Thermometers are like pens, they disappear, and having my own just prevents me from running around wasting time looking for one. If you decide to get your own thermometer, I recommend the Vicks one. It's a nice, thin, flexible tip and only takes 8 seconds to get a temp, which can be a lifesaver when working with animals. Like anything else, I recommend that you label your name on your thermometer. The next item is a reference guide, and it is the PDQ handbook. This may not be for everyone, but can be very helpful for newer techs. There is so much information to learn and know in vet med, and it can be very overwhelming to newer techs. The handbook is a great reference for pretty much most of the basic information newer techs will need to know. This is a lot of little things to have in your pocket. The next item I'm recommending is going to be a nursing pouch or belt. These belts really come in handy and make all your items easily accessible. I really like these belts. There is a place for everything and it makes it so much easier than looking through pockets to find what you need. You can find these belts at scrub stores online and even Etsy. Some people even make their own. The next thing is not an essential item, but more of a recommendation. Don't wear jewelry. You're working with animals and they are unpredictable. You never know when that switch will flip and you'll find yourself scrambling trying to control it. I've seen earrings get ripped out of ears, necklaces get pulled off, and rings get snagged or caught on collars. If it's something that means a lot to you, don't wear it when working with animals. Finally, the last two items are a lunchbox and water bottle. Veterinary medicine is fast-paced, non-stop atmosphere. Many hospitals and clinics don't give you a break or lunches. It's usually just too busy and short-staffed to provide techs with lunches or breaks. I recommend that you bring a quick snack to eat throughout the day when you can. Also, Always have a large water bottle with you. Being a tech is a very physically demanding job, and you will be drinking a lot of water. If you're interested in purchasing any of the items I have recommended, I will leave some links down below of the items I recommend. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell to get notified every time I post a new video.